So you always had to make this choice. Is it more important to be handheld, have the freedom, improvisation, or is it more important to have scene dialogue? Because you couldn't have both. You had to choose. So in the Lambeth Boys, there's one sequence where we wanted some of the dialogue to be usable. And I devised this blimp, portable blimp, which was made out of a sleeping bag. We just cut up a sleeping bag and we made various pieces. One went around the hood, one went around the motor, and one went around the whole body. There's a picture of me somewhere operating this camera, which was bulky but not heavy. And so you could get synch-sound, pseudo synch-sound, I'll call it. But it's in the film, it's perfectly effective. And then there's a proper synch-sound sequence in that film where the group of young boys featured in the film, because it's all centered on a youth hostel, on a youth club in southeast London, Lambeth. And so there's one sequence where they all get together for a weekly discussion. And the day we did it, the theme was capital punishment, and they were, my God, were they for it? They were all to a man for capital punishment on the basis of an eye for an eye. That is it, you know, that's the way you should be, you know, definitely. It was quite frightening to see these 14 and 16-year-olds being so definitely for capital punishment. So that sequence was a natural synch-sound sequence where it doesn't hurt if you have a camera on a tripod and lighting set up. But in many situations, if you need to set up a camera and lights, by the time you've done that, your subject has evaporated. It's very often the case. So you have to have two techniques available. And you have to choose between the spontaneity and the ability of capturing that spontaneity or synch sound. You couldn't have both. Now you can have both, but then you couldn't. And there's a very interesting sequence in the Lambeth Boys where they go to play their annual cricket match with a very high-nosed school in North London. And there's a nice lorry ride on the back of a lorry on the way to this cricket match. And then you have the cricket match itself, which again is there's no commentary at all on the cricket match. It just sets the scene. It tells every year they go to this place and they have a friendly cricket match with these public school boys, because in England, as you know, public school is a private school. Anyway, and that is a very interesting sequence because you have no need for commentary. You have these two groups, and they sort of eye each other warily, and then they play this match. The Lambeth Boys are in street clothes and sort of thrown together bits and pieces, and the public school boys are all in, and they've got their proper whites and their knee guards and their you know. One small pause for refreshment. So that's seeing that sequence is quite instructive because it shows that one of the parts of the Free Cinema Manifesto has definite meaning, because in that manifesto it says the image speaks, sound amplifies and comments, and that ought to be framed and hung up in every producer's office across the land and across the world, because nowadays the sound speaks and the image might just as well be turned off. A lot of films these days are like illustrated radio plays. All the information is in the dialogue. And there's a coda to all this, again, where many years later the BBC made a film, 20 years later, roughly in the 80s, I think it was, the BBC made a series called The Lambeth Boys, which was about the making of this film and what happened to the people in it. And it was in three parts. Each part was an hour long, and it was in colour, because BBC had gone into colour by then. And the first programme was a reshowing of the original film. And then the second part was following, they'd done some research and they'd followed up on what happened to those boys who are now grown up men. And they showed they found half a dozen of the people who'd been in that club, in that film, and they showed what they were doing nowadays. And then the third programme was showing what that club, which still existed, was like now. And in the interval between 58 and 84, say, The club had turned 100% black. It was now a black club because Lambeth was a black borough, very much so. And so that was the biggest difference. It was now a totally black club. And they interviewed the people there. And for me, the most interesting thing was not the actual content of the film, but what the technique used in the program, how the technique used to make that program different from the technique used to make the film. Because once again, in the program, it's a talking heads program. You have all these people, they appear on camera and they natter away and that's it. Whereas in the actual film, a lot of it is silent, and the image, it's the image that speaks. And that is the kind of film, to me, that is a must, that any halfway decent film, it has to be the image that speaks, not the soundtrack. The soundtrack is secondary.